thinking of the work around kindergarten readiness, I think the early learning context is really interesting because Mike Brown is doing a lot of work with our division with a PK through third leadership series. And our work on this goal really mirrors and mimics, I think, what districts are being asked to do for this broader age range. And so, I don't know, it's just a really interesting parallel that we are embarking on this work ourselves as districts are doing the same kind of thing. With kindergarten readiness, so we sort of started initially before we delved into the kindergarten readiness goal, we actually did a little stakeholder work because we naturally sort of fall into questions like that in our early learning space. So some questions and points that we raised: how do we ensure that there is an early learning representative on the world's best workforce local council? How can we, could we revise the summary template to ask the right questions? As far as membership, whether it's there's some pre-filled out categories where, you know, there's a place for the superintendent with their name, a place for the early learning representative to put their name, et cetera. Sort of specific roles detailed in that template. We talked about expanding the role of an advisory committee to include participants in plan, to include participating explicitly in the plan development. We also thought it might be helpful to sort of clarify what meaningfully involved is. Some examples of that could be like what type of outreach is necessary to find the right type of stakeholders to be engaged, and describe those outreach strategies. Talked about how local districts are ensuring diversity of the district is being representative, and how to ensure that the right parties are being invited and participating to make sure that they are representative. And maybe part of that is documenting, you know, asking them to specifically document outreach efforts. And then we sort of had a sub-question about more explicitly detailing the relationship between the advisory committee and the school board and detailing a little bit more what that looks like, what that back and forth engagement could be or should be, probably it could be. So that was more stakeholder engagement. Now we're gonna shift over towards the goal number one, kindergarten readiness. So some points that we thought of. We talked about providing guidance to reduce. So we have, the Early Learning Division produced a document that has, I think it was 11 different possible goals, sample goals, specific to kindergarten readiness, measuring kindergarten readiness. But we talked about trying to reduce the number of goals that we have in that document to make sure the ones that are present are really strong and really forward-thinking and encouraging districts to really stretch themselves in the right way. So we're thinking about that document, shrinking it down a little bit to make it more, fewer goals, more structured. I'm not gonna remember the exact page, but there's a data site for the world's best workforce that you can link to, and we know that it doesn't necessarily specify goal one, goal two, goal three, goal four, goal five, but it does talk about you select the type of goal, and one of them is kindergarten readiness, so when you click on it, you select the year, and it's supposed to pull up data sources. For this goal, it doesn't provide any data sources. So we thought that was very telling, and probably if districts are using that website for ideas about where to go, we need to provide a little bit more detail about where they can go for data sources. We talked about mimicking what some of the other folks said, that example goals point districts to looking at all children in the community. So in addition to covering all subgroups, we really talked about thinking about pre-kindergarten and the definition of pre-kindergarten, all children before kindergarten, and thinking a little more holistically about their school district as inclusive of children in childcare. We talked about the fact that our guidance, actually our example goals, has both qualitative and quantitative goals in them, and some of the qualitative goals might have to do more with process, but we think that some of those goals could really push districts to do more work to get to a better place to find the data and identify the data that they need to have more quantitative goals. We talked about the possibility of conducting some trainings with COE staff on early learning, so we know that the team is being built out significantly, and we want to make sure that they have an early learning lens as they provide TA to our districts. And then providing some professional development that provides districts with examples of how to move from data collection to analysis to then goal setting, and sort of that structured, tiered, just because you have data or you report on data doesn't mean that you're moving the ball forward, but really helping them think explicitly about those sequence of steps. And I think some of this lends itself to the fact that sometimes it's easy to think about this work as a one-shot deal, one summary, one plan, but really they're connected and it's a continuous improvement process, which ties back in to the work that Mike Brown has been doing with our pre-K through third grade leadership series, which is, it's not a one-time deal, this is a ongoing year-to-year process where you might not get the goals right the first time. Our first guidance, we have 11 goals, some of them might not be the best, but in our next iteration of guidance, let's get more specific, let's get a little bit better.